أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. جزاكم الله خير وبارك الله فيكم for coming and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by His great name to be merciful to us in dunya and akhirah and to accept our own good deeds and make it in our balance in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla at the day of judgment. We still with the Surah Al-Hujurat. And Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, out of the six calls from Allah Azza wa Jal to the believers, saying, O you who believe, in Arabic, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make six times, five of it start with Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, last one start with Ya ayyuha alnas, which include Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu also, include the believers. First one, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, do not make decision before Allah, before Rasulullah, and also you have no choice after He decides. After Allah decides something, and after Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam decide, there is no choice for the believer. And this is the ayah I read in the salah itself. مَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمْ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. Not for the believer, men or a woman, when Allah decides something, they have no choice except what Allah decides. Then we move to the second one. Never raise your voice in front of Rasulullah. This is at the time, lifetime of Rasulullah. Respect him also if you are in front of the grave, and respect the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Should be no argue about the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then we move to the third one. O you who believe, the third call, if anyone bringing to you bad news, verify it before you act upon it. Verify it before you act upon it. Then number four contains the ayah itself three order. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, la yaskhar qawmun min qawm. Should not be any group of people mocking at or putting down or scoff at any other people. No individual also. Nobody should mock at or يعني putting down or backbiting anyone. ولا تلمزوا أنفسكم. Do not defame one another. ولا تنابزوا بالألقاب. Never insult one another by the nicknames. Very important to know that. Then the last time we stop with the ayah or the call, actually, number 5, which it is Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah 49, ayah number 12. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِسْمٍ وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَوَّابٌ رَّحِيمٌ. O you who believe, avoid much of suspicion. Do not be suspicious. Every behavior of other you suspected, and you think bad about them, and you interpretate the behavior of the other. Oh, they did this because of that, they said this because of that. This is not allowed in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِسْمٍ. Some of the suspicion and suspect and being doubtful is a sin. You will commit a sin when you do it. Then, second order, وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا. Never spy upon each other. Never try to find the fault of somebody else in order to say it to others. Even without saying to another. Allah order you, لَا تَجَسَّسُوا. Do not spy upon one another. Do not spy, do not try to find the mistakes of the other. Do not try to dig behind him. The third order in the same ayah, وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا. Should not be one of you backbiting any other one. Then Allah give example. أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَنْ يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ. Do you like to eat the flesh of your dead brother while he is a dead? You eat his flesh. Will you hate that? As you hate that, you should hate backbiting. Then, let us go now with details about that. Step by step and one by one. For the first one in it, in this ayah, avoid much suspicion. Do not be doubtful. because Shaitan is the one who will bring the doubt to you, doubting your brother, doubting his behavior, doubting his saying, and suspect is not allowed. Because suspect, first thing, will destroy communities and will destroy and cut the tie between you and the others. And this doubt and this suspect will never bring any good. He was saying that and he means that. And this is will lead you to the second forbidden thing. First, it is forbidden. Second one, it is also forbidden to lead you to spy because you doubt. In order to confirm your doubt, what will you do? You will spy. Allah said, you stop, no spy. When you doubt, when you suspect, it will make you to find out. Find out means spying upon the other. Oh, did he do that or he doesn't do it? Allah said to you, وَلَا تَجَسَّسُوا. Do not spy. And if you spy, it will lead you also to the third one, backbiting. You will go tell the people, he did this and she did that and who did this. This group is not and this. It will create more problems. For that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it three forbidden in the same ayah because everyone will bring and lead you to the second one. Sa'id ibn Musayyam, he said, I wrote to some of the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying to them, put the matter of your brother on the best of it, not on the worst of it. Put of the matter of the others on the best of it. And take every word from your other brother with the best of it. Even it is having a good meaning and bad meaning, because sometimes the same word, it could be interpreted with good way, could be also interpreted with a bad way. Sa'id ibn Musayyab saying, take it with the good way and leave the bad way. As long as there is a way for it to be interpreted with good. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, maybe one word and the same word said by two people. One of them, one of these two people, يريد بها أعظم الباطل ويريد الآخر محد الحق. Is it maybe the same word be used? One, he say it with the intention of bad and he want with it all kind of evil and wrong and haram. Same word can be used by another one and he want with it the truth and the right and the halal. There is big difference. Then he said how? الاعتبار بطريقة القائل وسيرته ومذهبه ونيته وما يدعو إليه وينظر عنه. He said, you will know what does it mean for that one because of the way he said it and the biography of this man from background. Biography is wrong word. The background of this one and what is the intention he want to say. For him, he knows it. And also whatever he calling for. Somebody calling for sunnah, somebody for calling for other than the sunnah. There is no any doubt it could be the same word using for both two people. The one who will call for sunnah, meaning of this word will be different than the one who call for other than the sunnah. For that he said, Ibn al-Qayyim said to what he looking for, what he calling for, how he is behaving. And where is the proof from the sunnah he bring it? There is one hadith, a man, he was the summary of the hadith. He get lost in the desert. And he get lost in the transportation, the animal, donkey or horse or whatever, run away. And he was looking until he was feeling that he will die. No doubt he will die. He slept waiting for the death. Then all of a sudden when he wake up, he find in front of him the animal he lost and the food over it and the drink. He felt so happy. Out of this happiness, he should say what? Allahumma anta rabbi wa ana abduk. Oh Allah, I am thankful to you. You are my Lord and I am your slave. He said opposite. Rasulullah mentioned that hadith. He said, Allahumma anta abdi wa ana rabbuk. Astaghfirullah. He said, oh Allah, you are my slave and I am your Lord. Out of the happiness. Does Rasulullah say about him he's a kafir? No, he does not. Because he doesn't mean to make himself a Lord. It doesn't mean he to make himself, even the word is wrong. And this is if you go back to about the lectures of the kufr. قَدْ يَقُولُ الْقَائِلُ كَلِمَةَ الْكُفْرِ وَلَيْسَ بِكَافِرٍ. Maybe somebody will pronounce and say the word of kufr while he is not. Like this one, this is an example of that. It depends upon the intention. There is no any doubt. For that different from one to another one. But in Islam, is it allowed for you to interpret it wrong or to twist the meaning of it or to try to find the mistakes or to doubt or to suspect and to bad thinking about the other? All of this is not allowed. What the treatment for all of this? order of Allah Azza wa Jal for you, avoid the suspicion, avoid the doubt, avoid the bad thinking with the Muslim, and always good think about them, and always try to treat them with the way you want them to treat you. And also, before you say anything and before you doubt anything, think about it. Think about it many, many times. Another thing, a rule, very good rule for you. Suppose you think good and you was wrong. And even you think good about him and you was wrong, better than you think bad and you was wrong. Right or wrong? If you think good about him, then later you discover my thinking good about him was not right. Is there any harm? Is there any problem? There is no problem. And this is this case. You think good about him and he was not suitable for that. He was not يعني, qualified for that. Better than you think bad about him, even you are right. Even you are right. Because Allah said to you, do not think bad about the others. Allah said, وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْضُكُمْ بَعْضًا. Should not any one of you backbite the other one. What is now in Islam? There are three words. الغيبة, الإفك, البهتان. غيبة is backbiting, saying something behind him. وهي في العربي ذكر العيب بظهر الغيب وهي فيه. Mentioning something wrong in him and it is in him. This is its name, backbiting, because you should not mention, you should not find a fault of your brother in order to say it. الإفك. الإفك ذكر العيب بظهر الغيب وليست فيه. الإفك, no, no. الإفك إذا قلت فيه ما بلغك عنه. When you say about the other, whatever you receive from others. You heard it, then you transfer it. This is ifk, committing sin. And it is a great sin in Islam. Al-buhtan, when you mention something about him and it is not in him. When you mention something, it will be backbiting if it is in him. You say about him, he's short, and you mean to put him down. And it is, he is. Still it is backbiting. If he doesn't like it, and he should not say it. But what about if I mention something and it is not in him, buhtan, a great sin in Islam. Look to the order of Rasulullah and order of Allah Azza wa Jal. In Imam Ahmad and also in Imam Abu Dawood, 4880, Abu Ya'la, 1675, Imam Al-Albani said it is Hassan and Sahih. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد يا معشر من آمن بلسانه ولم يدخل الإيمان قلبه لا تغتاب المسلمين. Oh, you who believe only by his tongue and the iman and the faith does not touch and does not enter his heart, he said, do not backbite the Muslims. Look towards the description of رسول الله to those people. He believed by his tongue and he does not have any iman, because if you have iman in your heart, will prevent your tongue from talking and backbiting the other. Because the ayah we are in, the order in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number 6 is, firstly, O you who believe, do not suspect, and do not spy, and do not backbite each other. For that, I am going with these three together. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, do not backbiting them, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا عَوَرَاتِهِمْ. Do not follow their fault. Do not dig behind your brother. فَإِنَّ مَنْ تَتَبَّعَ عَوْرَةَ أَخِيهِ تَتَبَّعَ اللَّهُ عَوْرَتَهِ وَمَنْ تَتَبَّعَ اللَّهُ عَوْرَتَهِ يَفْضَحُهُ وَلَوْ فِي جَوْفِ بَيْتِهِ. Whoever follows the mistakes of the other in order to dig behind him to expose it to others, Allah Azza wa Jal himself will expose your mistake. Even the one you don't know in your house, Allah will expose it to the people. You prevent yourself from digging behind the others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover your mistake. You try to find out the mistakes of the other in order to say to the others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expose your mistake to the other. For that, this is a punishment for him. Salaf al-Salih, some of the Salaf al-Salih, they say, أدركنا السلف الصالح وهم لا يرون العبادة في الصوم والصلاة فقط ولكن في الكف عن أعراض الناس. Said, we catch the Sahaba and the Salaf after the Sahaba, some of the one who come later, said, we catch them while they do not see only عبادة, worshiping of Allah, not only in Psalm, not only in Salah, not only in Zakah, but also by يعني controlling your tongue and not backbiting others. This is part of the ibadah, to control your tongue and not to backbite the others. And look also to the reward. We already say the punishment. Allah will expose your mistakes if you try to dig behind your brother. What is the reward if you do? يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من ذب عن عرض أخيه بالغيب كان حقا على الله أن يعتقه من النار. Whoever defend his brother in his absence, Instead of backbiting him and put him down and bring his mistakes and suspect him and bad think bad about him, whoever defend his brother in his absence, it is right upon Allah. And Allah is the one who put his right upon himself. Right upon Allah that he will release you from hellfire. That he will save you and protect you from hellfire. Also, there is another hadith bringing another punishment for the one who doesn't do. Abu Dawood and Imam Ahmad, من قال في مؤمن ما ليس فيه أسكنه الله رضغة الخبالي. Whoever say about his brother, whatever not in him, he is angry from him, and he tried to dig behind him to find any mistake he does not find, then he lie. And he say, oh, he have this and he did this and he does not do that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put him in a place in Jahannam. It's the name رضغة الخبال. They asked Rasulullah, what is رضغة الخبال? قال عسارة أهل النار والعياذ بالله. He said that, how I say it, is the blood and the pus and the bad liquids coming out from the people of Jahannam. This is the will be the place for him to stay in. Any bad liquid, have bad smell and bad looking from the people of Jahannam, this is together, it will be the place that one who backbite and who mentioned something he is not in his brother will be his place to stay. And he will not get out of it. حتى يخرج مما قال وليس بخارج. He will never get out of it until he get out of what he say. And he cannot. Day of judgment cannot. What does it mean? Control yourself now. Ask Allah to forgive you if this has already happened before. If there is no problem, it will not create problem. Ask your brother to forgive you. But it will, if it will create problem, ask Allah to forgive you and him. Also, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, in the journey of الإسراء والمعراج, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take him to the seven heaven, he said, مررت بقوم لهم أظفار من نحاس. He said, I passed by a people, have their nails out, made out of copper, metal. يخمشون وجوههم وصدورهم. They are scratching their faces and their chest. And they are يعني, doing so bad to themselves with this metal and the copper nails. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يا جبريل, who is those people? قال هؤلاء الذين يأكلون لحوم الناس ويقعون في أعراضهم. He said, this is the people who backbite the others and they try to put them down and they try to find out their mistakes and going behind them to do wrong. This is a punishment for them in the day of judgment. They will be وَلَعَيَذُ بِاللَّهِ in Jahannam and having their own nails, copper and metals and scratching their faces and their chest. But is it all kind of غيبة and backbiting haram? No. There is some reasons it makes the غيبة itself halal and no more غيبة. What it is? التظلم. Complain. Allah Azza wa Jal says that in Surah An-Nisa 148, لا يحب الله الجهر بالسوء من القول إلا من ظلم. Somebody did wrong against your own self. And did in Arabic ظلم. ضاء لام ميم. Allah says in Surah An-Nisa, ayah number 148, Allah does not like any evil. Does not like any evil to be said or uttered in public, any evil or bad words, except Allah Azza wa Jal said, except whoever been wronged, whoever been wronged from other, he can go, but not everybody. No, he goes for the responsible. Suppose he goes to the judge, he can complain to him. He go to for the imam, can complain to him. This is allowed in Islam. Second one, also. Seeking help of changing the evil or the wrong or the bid'ah, but with the good intention of stop the people from doing the haram and the wrong. This is allowed in Islam. Allowed in Islam. Number three, it will not be backbiting. Also asking for fatwa and saying that this man did so and so and so wrong against me, or this rose between me and him, this and that, and he cheat me. The word cheat here. It's not a backbiting because you need to explain in order to get a fatwa about what you want. Also, advising the people, and especially if there is some kind of dealing would be between the like marriages, and one of the family come to you to ask about that other family, and you know that the other family is not good, allowed for you to say. Somebody coming to have a business with somebody else, and he come to ask, is this man good, honest or not? Allowed for an Islam to know, to say it also. Suppose somebody want to trust somebody else for some money, for some amana. Amana in Arabic, are he trustworthy or no? It's not allowed for you to lie. And at the same time, is it backbiting? No, it's not. Suppose you want to ask him to do some job for you, and you don't know nothing about him. Some people they come actually to some of the relative or some of the, يعني the ones they know him and they ask. Sometimes they come to the Imam and ask. It's not allowed for you that he is bad and you say he's good. They will be forbidden. It was allowed for you in Islam to mention what about him. Or that this is very important to know also. جرح المجروحين من الشهود والرواة جائز بالإجماع. If some people of the narrator of the hadith is a liar, already the ulama say about them that he is a liar. This is not backbiting. Why? Because it is clarifying about him. Should we accept the hadith from that man or no? Also, المجاهر بفسقه أو ببدعته. The one who do haram or wrong or committing any wrong, taking rashwat, taking bribery, openly, or committing any kind of bid'ah openly, allowed to backbite him. And it is not counted in Islam as backbiting. For that, also anyone who break any orders of Allah from Quran or from the Sunnah, you can say, Rasulullah himself, when he see one of the people, he say, بِئْسَ أَخُ الْعَشِيرَةِ. This is the worst one of the people. Rasulullah said it in al-Bukhari. Is another hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم about two people, ما أظن فلانا وفلانا سماهم النبي يعرفون من ديننا شيئا. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, and this hadith is 6067 and 6068. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I don't think this man and this man know from our religion anything at all. Is this backbiting? No. It's not a backbiting, because Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم did it, and this explanation saying that if somebody, the people want to follow him and you know that he doesn't know, it's not wrong to say he doesn't know. Is not wrong. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he say, بِئْسَ أَخُ الْعَشِيرَةِ. This is the worst kind of people. That this is very important to make it clear. Otherwise, people will be deceived and people will be cheated while you are helping them to cheat and to deceive. Also, one of the things is allowed is التعريف بالشخصي. When you try to identify somebody to somebody else, and you try, you know this Muhammad, you know this Ahmed, he say no. And then you try to describe him. He is little bit heavy, he is little bit tall, but with a good intention. Not with a mocking way, not with putting him down. For that, description with a good intention, only just to let him know about the person you want him to know, no problem with that. But what about if your intention, you are mentioning it to put him down and to criticize him? This is one is not allowed in Islam and forbidden. For that, save yourself. And if suppose you commit something of that, do tawbah and listen to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, من كانت لأخيه عنده مظلمة من عرض أو مال فليتحلله اليوم قبل أن يؤخذ منه. يوم لا دينار ولا درهم. فإن كان له عمل صالح أخذ منه بقدر مظلمته. وإن لم يكن له عمل صالح أخذ من سيئات صاحبه فجعلت عليه. Listen to this hadith carefully. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم warning us, saying to you, if suppose your brother, you know that he have right upon you. You did something wrong against him. And he have a right upon you. He said, of the ird, means backbiting him or doing wrong against him, so against his personality, against his money. He said, ask in the worldly life for him to forgive you. Before it will be at the day of judgment, it will be taken from you. There is no dinar or dirham. Suppose a wrong you do between you and him was about money. No money in the akhirah, but only good deeds and bad deeds. Rasulullah say, no dinar, no dirham. It will be the good deeds and bad deeds. إن كان له عمل صالح أخذ منه بقدر مظلمته. If suppose you did wrong against that man and you have a good deeds, he will take your good deeds to him equal to the wrong you did against him. Suppose you do not have any good deeds, it will taken from his bad deeds, from his bad record, put upon you equal to the wrong you did. For that, either in the dunya, even it is little bit disgraceful to ask your brother to forgive you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, please forgive me. There was one mistake from my side against you. This is will be better and easier. Now let us move to the last call in Surah An-Nisa, which started with Ya Ayyuhan Nasu. Allah Azza wa Jal said in Surah An-Nisa, and Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah number 49, Ayah number 13. Allah said, Ya Ayyuhan Nas, Inna Khalaqnakum Min Dhakarin Wa Unsa, وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم إن الله عليم خبير. Oh people, this is call for whole human being. يا أيها الناس, oh people, الله سبحانه وتعالى call مؤمن غير مؤمن. إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى. We create you from a male and female. وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا. الله سبحانه وتعالى say, and we made you nation, different nations and different tribes in order to know each other. One of the Islamic teaching, know each other. One of the default in your personality, if your brother beside you and you don't know him, and you don't know his name, and you don't know nothing about him. For that in Islam, Allah say, we create whole human being, different tribes, different nation, in order for them to know each other. But there is no any doubt, know each other and respect each other and cooperate for every good and love each other and be nice to each other. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The most honorable one of you with Allah, the most honorable and respected one with Allah is that believer who has more taqwa. The most respected one, the one in high in degree with Allah, is the one who have more taqwa, more iman, more belief, more practicing of the deen. Let us go more with explanation عن ابن عمر that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم at the day of opening of Mecca that he did a khutbah and he said, oh people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by this Islam remove the jahiliya from you and remove the arrogant of the way of the jahiliya and also the way of being feeling يعني arrogant and feeling proud of your parent. فالناس رجلان. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, listen, he said the people is two different kind. People, men or women, two different kind. بر تقي كريم على الله ونسأل الله أن نكون منهم آمين أو فاجر شقي هين على الله. Two different kind. One, بر تقي كريم على الله. بر, righteous. تقي, have تقوى. Believe. Is beloved to Allah. He is honorable with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one kind. Opposite of that, instead of righteous, evil. Instead of taqi, shaqi. Shaqi is wicked. Shaqi and evil and wicked and bad. Hayyinu ala Allah. Have no weight with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have nothing. This is confirmed by another hadith also. One of the signs of the day of Qiyamah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the people will be two groups. Whole human being, two. Or any community is two, any family is two. What it is? قال فسطاط إيمان لا نفاق فيه وفسطاط نفاق لا إيمان فيه والعياذ بالله. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say, people will be near to the day of judgment. A group of people have إيمان, no نفاق. Pure إيمان, no any kind of hypocrisy. Or opposite, والعياذ بالله. وأسك الله سيفا, say آمين. The other group, pure منافق. Your hypocrite have no any kind of iman. And the problem with those kind of the munafiq, the hypocrite, they think that they are better than sahaba. They think always because they don't know, they don't feel. Sometimes if the pain itself becomes too much, it goes away. He have a lot of nifaq while he doesn't feel it at all. Sahaba themselves is in order not to feel bad. And sahaba themselves is used to ask each other. Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali. Go read about their own story. They used to ask each other, أَتَرَى فِيَّ نِفَاقًا? Did you see nifaq in me? But because they know very well, even with the all good of deeds, that this is something can goes to their heart while they don't feel it. To ask Allah, say Ameen. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, وَالنَّاسُ بَنُوا آدَمْ. All the people is son of Adam. We are equal in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. And Adam created from the dust. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say in the Quran al-Kareem, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى in the ayah. And we create you from a male and female, and we create you different nations and different tribes in order to know each other. In البخاري ومسلم agreed upon عن سهل بن سعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, and this hadith is very important, listen to it. Sometimes some people you look down to them and they are with Allah better than millions than you. Hadith of Rasulullah himself. البخاري ومسلم agreed upon. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting with one of the people. And one man passing. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, what do you think about that? Rasulullah asked the man who was beside him upon the passing, the one who was walking. What do you think about this man? What's your opinion exactly? ما رأيك في هذا? What's your opinion about this man? That man, he said, Ya Rasulullah, رجل من أشرف الناس. This is man of the honorable one. Have a big dignity. And he said, by Allah, this man, if he go for marriage, everybody will give him the marriage. هذا حري إن خطب أن ينكح وإن شفع أن يشفع وفي رواية وإن قال أن يسمع له فسكت رسول الله. He said, if he goes for marriage, people will give him their daughter. And if he goes for intercession, it will be accepted right away. And if he talk, everybody will listen to him. Talkative. Very power talk. Rasulullah kept quiet. After a while, another man passed. Rasulullah asked the same man, what do you think about, what's your opinion about that one? He said, Ya Rasulullah, and this is in Bukhari al-Muslim. Ya Rasulullah, رجل من فقراء المسلمين. هذا حري إن خطب ألا ينكح وإن شفع ألا يشفع وإن قال ألا يسمع لقوله. He said, Ya Rasulullah, from a poor people, poor of the Muslims. This man, if he goes for marriage, nobody will give him his daughter. And if he goes for shafa'ah, for intercession between problems and some, nobody will listen to him, nobody will accept his shafa'ah. And if he say, if he talk, nobody will listen to him. Do you know what Rasulullah said? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا خير من ملء الأرض من مثل هذا. سبحان الله. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, this one, the one in your eye, is a poor man, and nobody will accept his shafa'ah, nobody will accept him to marry his daughter, nobody will listen to his talking. He said, this man is better than full of the earth of the other one. Better than full of the earth of the other one. We ask Allah make us like that man. Good people. How it will be? Control your tongue. Please, for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Control it. هل يكب الناس في النار على وجوههم إلا حصائد ألسنتهم? Is there anything will make the people to fall down in Jahannam? Except the harvest of their tongue. The harvest of their tongue. Either good, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Or bad, ask Allah save us. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, four things related to the ayah also. Four things from the jahiliya way. الفخر بالأحساب. Being proud and يعني arrogant of all my own family and my own father and my own brother and my own this and that, and I have in my family 10 doctors and 15 engineers and the rest Allah knows about them. Subhanallah, ya akhi. No. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. The most honorable one within you is the one who have more taqwa. If you are with the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hi, this is alhamdulillah. But if you are not, doesn't matter, it will never help you. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say from the jahiliya way, الطعن في الأنساب, backbiting others and doubting also the offspring of the people. والاستسقاء بالنجوم. الاستسقاء بالنجوم have many ways. Depend upon the stars of many things. One of it is the coming of the rain. Number four, one of the jahiliya in this hadith, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of the jahiliya way is يعني screaming and yelling and crying with a very loud voice at the time of the death and at the time of the calamities. Then let us now move to the brotherhood in Islam and the reasons and the levels of the brotherhood in Islam. Because this ayat, whatever we take before and whatever we explain of this ahadith, talking about be brothers, be united, love each other, forgive the mistakes of each other. Everyone have mistakes, nobody is perfect. Every single one, without any, except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the one who is perfect because brought up by Allah himself. And Allah give him a big certificate in the Quran, إِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are in a great khuluq. Other than this, everybody of us have some mistakes and some default and some good and some bad. Do not look to the bad of your brother. Look to your own. And try to correct it. Try to sing. But there is some, it will help you to do that. To have brotherhood, to have cooperation. Number one, in Surah Al-Hashr, Surah number 59, Ayah number 9, Allah said part of the ayah, وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. They give the others preference over their own selves, even though they were in need of that. If you reach to that, Allah praises those kind of people. They give the preference to the other. Preference of good, preference of whatever they have with them, even they need it. Some food you have, even you need it. You prefer others sincerely for the sake of Allah to give it to him or to them, even you need it, even you are in need of it. This is the name in Arabic, Al-Ithar. Al-Ithar, it is you prefer others over your own self, and this is, was one of the degree of the Sahaba Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Hashr. What about if I'm not able? At least, ya akhi, love for your own brother, whatever you love for your own self. You do not like anybody to backbite you. Do not backbite the other. You do not like anybody to dig behind you and find your mistakes. Do not dig behind the other and find their own mistakes. You do not like for anybody to find out your mistakes and spread it to the people. Do not do the same. Also, to do that, control your tongue, control your hand. Rasulullah s.a.w. said in hadith, very famous, Muslim is the brother of the Muslim. One of the meaning, comprehensive meaning of this hadith, have a lot in the hadith, he does not do wrong against him, he does not put him down, he does not insult him, he does not backbite him, he does not even with the eye or with the hand. And sometimes some of the moving of the eye, you close your eye and you move it, and you shake your head, means he's nothing, he's garbage, right? Should not even do that. Or by hand, leave him alone. No, it should not. And do not also think bad about him. Always think good, because this will lead you to think good about Allah or think bad about Allah Azza wa Jal. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say, hadith in Bukhari number 10, and Muslim 41, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Muslim, the real Muslim, the true Muslim, is the one other Muslims save from his tongue and hand. Save from his tongue and his hand. How the other Muslim will be saved? Wallahi by Allah. I'm saying to some of the people, you will fear to meet them because of their tongue. Wal'iyadhu billah. Some calamity, he will come out, it will come out from their mouth to you. Well, ask Allah, save us, ya akhi. Be careful. At the same time, Allah give you a power of talking, control it. Control your tongue, because the harvest of the tongue is for you or against you. What is the reward if you save your Muslim brother from a munafiq, from a hypocrite? Sunan Abu Dawood, hadith 4883, and the hadith al-Imam al-Albani say it is sahih, and it is 4086. And Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, من حمى مؤمنا من منافق يعيبه يغتابه بعث الله إليه ملكا يحمي لحمه يوم القيامة من نار جهنم. The reward of saving your brother from a munafiq. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, whoever save his mu'min, his brother, mu'min brother, from a munafiq, and this munafiq backbiting him and insulting him and putting him down, and he tried to create problems to him. If you save your Muslim brother from that kind of people, Allah will send an angel to save your body from the hellfire at the day of judgment. Allah will send angel at the day of judgment to save you from the hellfire, because you saved your Muslim brother from that munafiq who backbite and who try to find the mistakes and create problems. Also, the same hadith, وَمَنْ رَمَى مُؤْمِنًا بِشَرٍ يُرِيدُ شَيْنَهُ أي سُبَّتَهُ حَبَسَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى جِسْرِ جَهَنَّمْ حَتَّى يَخُرْجَ مِنْ مَعْقَالٍ. And whoever tried to attack somebody else and he tried to make him look bad, and he tried to find his mistakes behind him and dig, as already the ayah forbidding that, Allah will keep him upon the bridge in Jahannam. And this bridge, as we know, is thinner than the hair and sharper than the razor. Sharper than the razor. And he will be staying upon it in Jahannam, in the middle of Jahannam, until he get out of what he said in dunya. And he will never be able. In another hadith, Abu Dawood 4884, عن أبي طلحة ابن سهل الأنصاري قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما أن من امرئ يخزل امرأ مسلما في موضع تنتهك فيه حرمته وينتقص فيه من عرضه إلا خذله الله في مواطن يحب فيها نصرته. Anyone disgracing another Muslim one and he is attending, you did not disgrace by yourself, somebody disgracing somebody else and you are attending there, and you see that they're backbiting him and putting him down and they try to create problems to him, and you did not defend, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you to be disgraced in a place you love to be honored. Do you understand it or no? Sometimes you like to be honored and respected in some situations. In order to be raised and to be honored and to be respected in this situation, if there is somebody is attacked and somebody is backbited, and you were attending, try for the sake of Allah to defend. If you defend, Allah will defend you, as already the hadith saying. But if you do not, some people see fire, going on fire means backbiting, he put gas. He increases it. Instead of decreasing it, if you increase it, or you did not help to decrease it, Rasulullah SAW say, Allah will disgrace you in a place you like to be honored, and you like to be raised, and you like to be praised. You will not. But what about if you وما من امرئ ينصر امرئا مسلما في موضع ينتقص فيه من عرضه وينتهك فيه من حرمته الا نصره الله في مواطن يحب فيها نصرته. If any Muslim helping Muslim other Muslim while it has been attacked and putting down and they try to backbite him and mention some of his mistakes except Allah and he defend, Allah will defend you in a place you love to be defended. Allah will defend you in a places you love to be defended. Because Allah Azza wa Jal does not look to our own deeds. Allah does not look to our own shape or our own body. The hadith of Rasulullah in Muslim and Ibn Majah 4143, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Inna Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum wa la li amwalikum. Allah does not look to your shape, to your body, not to your money, how much money you have. Walakin yanzuru ila qulubikum wa a'malikum. But he looked to your heart and to your amal. He looked to your heart. Allah knows what's your heart. You remember the ayah I read in the khutbah that Allah Azza wa Jal say, Wallahu ya'lamu ma fi qulubikum. Allah knows what's in your heart. Allah knows what's in your heart. For that Allah does not look to you in a body, look to you as about the money, how much money you have. No. Allah looked to your heart and your good deeds or bad. In Ahmad and Jabir, he said, we was when with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one time, فهاجت ريح منتنة. Was come a wind with a very, very, very bad smell. Worst smell. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, this wind coming because some of the munafiqeen backbite some of the Muslim. Some of the munafiqeen, hypocrite, backbiting the Muslim. For that this reason, this bad wind comes. وعن عمر بن الخطاب إن القرطبي volume number 16 page number 220 قال إياكم وذكر الناس فإنه داء وعليكم بذكر الله فإنه شفاء. سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب he said be careful and I'm warning you against mentioning the mistakes of the other people because it is a sickness. Sickness if you get used to it you will be habit. All the time when you see somebody complaining about everything. No. Do not make it your habit. Complain about your own self to your own self and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Correct your own self. Then Rasulullah Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab saying that and be careful and I'm advising you keep your tongue busy with the zikr of Allah. This is a cure for that disease. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one time he did a khutbah saying, oh people, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, your Lord is only one and your father is only one, Sayyidina Adam. And there is no any superiority of anyone over any other one. No for Arabi, Abun Ajami. No for Ajami, Abun Arabi. No for Abiyad, white, over a black. No for a black, Abun white, except by taqwa. Except by fear of Allah. Except by your faith. Except by your strong iman. And then Rasulullah SAW say, little bit more than the other hadith. Allah does not look to your body. Allah does not look to your family. Allah does not look to you whom marry from. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look also to your money, ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم. But he looked to your heart. For that whoever have a good deeds and good intention, and he does not think bad, does not suspect, does not backbiting, this is the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love. And this is the Rasulullah say, أحبكم إلى الله أتقاكم. The most beloved one to Allah is the one who have more taqwa. ومن أحب أن يكون أكرم الناس فليتق الله. And whoever loved to be the most honorable one, most يعني respected one, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In al-Tabarani, min hadith ibn Umar, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, my friends, my wali, my helper, my real follower, Rasulullah say, my real follower is the one at the day of judgment. is not by the nasab, is not by the blood relation, but people will come at the day of judgment with their own mistakes upon their own head. And those kind of people, they will come with the good deeds. This is my wali. This is my real follower. This is the one who got come in front of Allah with the good deeds. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in Sahih Muslim, قال, أَلَا إِنَّا آلَ أَبِي فُلَانٍ لَيْسُوا لِي بِأَوْلِيَاءِ إِنَّمَا وَلِيَّ اللَّهُ وَصَالِحُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Rasulullah mentioned one of the tribes, family of so and so, he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, they are not my own follower. Do you like Rasulullah to say to you that at the day of judgment, at the day of judgment, day of Qiyamah? Ask yourself this question. Ask yourself this question. Is it what you are doing will make you close to Allah, close to Rasulullah, or no? If it is not, be far from it. Do you like Rasulullah come and the day of Qiyamah say, as he said about these people, they are not my follower. I don't like these people. Then he said, إِنَّمَا وَلِيَّ اللَّهُ وَصَالِحُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. My wali, my protector, my helper is Allah, and then my friends from the dunya, and my near people to me is صالح المؤمنين, the righteous people of the mu'min. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم one time was asked, who is the most generous and respected and honorable one, ya Rasulullah? Who is in high degree, dignity, have high dignity? He said, Yusuf ibn Ya'qub ibn Ishaq ibn Ibrahim, Sayyidina Yusuf, the messenger. He said, ya Rasulullah, we are not asking about that. He said, فَأَكْرَمُهُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاهُمْ. This is the one related to our topic. He said, the most respected one and high with Allah is the one who have more taqwa. And this is, you cannot know it by yourself. You cannot know about the others. You can know about yourself after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's not nothing that you can judge the people. Do not judge. It is between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe in your eye he is bad, but with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he is good. Right or wrong? As the hadith of Rasulullah asked, what about this man? He said, oh, so good and so يعني, acceptable, and he's talking, everybody will listen, and his shafa'ah will accept it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say about the other man, who he was saying about him that he is not poor, and nobody will not listen to him, nobody will marry him, nobody will accept his intercession. Rasulullah said, one of those better than full of the whole earth. Imagine now, whole earth, how many billion? Answer me. Seven. Almost 7 billion. Rasulullah say, one of this kind better than 7 billion. According to our own calculation now. Imagine if you are one of those. But this is, you will not get it from the air. No more revelation. You have to act and to do according to it. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, the most honorable one is the one who have more taqwa. They said, ya Rasulullah, we are not asking about that. We are asking about the Arab at that time, before Islam and after Islam. Because some of them were so hard against Islam, before Islam. Then after that become so good. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, خيارهم في الجاهلية, خيارهم في الإسلام إذا فاقهوا. The best one of them in جاهلية, the best one of them in جاهلية is the best one of them be in Islam, but if he understands the religion. This is a condition for us. You will be the best if you understand your religion. And you try to apply out of love to Allah, out of love to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Out of love to Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Out of love to be in Al-Jannah. Out of also hatred to be in Jahannam. Out of hatred that Rasulullah will say about you, no, no, this is not my follower. We ask Allah save us from that. Allahumma gfir lana dhunubana. Allahumma kaffir anna sayyatina. Allahumma tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husn ibadatik. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdibina wa ja'alna sawan liman ihtada. Allahumma inna nas'aluka bismika al-a'zam al-huda wa tuqa wa al-afaf wa al-ghina. واغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم انصرنا ولا تنصر علينا, واعنا ولا تعن علينا, وانصرنا على من بغى علينا, واهدنا ويسر الهدى إلينا, واجعلنا في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصرنا, واخذل من خذلنا, واهدنا واهد بنا, واجعلنا سبب لمن اهتدى. ومن مكر بنا فامكر به, واجعل مكرهم يحيق بهم ويدمرهم تدميرا, واجعل مكر أولئك هو يبور, واجعل كيدهم في تضليل وتباب, واصرفهم وابعدهم وانقلهم وارحنا وارح العباد والبلاد والشجر والدواب منهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل, ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل, وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزانا وجزاكم الله خيرا. I'm asking you by the great name of Allah, always remember me in the best of your dua, and the angel will return the same dua you do to you, inshallah. You do good dua, the angel will return it to you the same good dua. You do bad, ask Allah save us from that, angel will return the same to you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.